Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to the Banner Saga 2. We are at some petrified flames that have apparently warded off our Varl. Let's take a look at it. Placed upside down on the ground, the petrified roots of a giant tree reach toward the sky. All the Varl, including Ivar and Hakan, have separated from the caravan temporarily, giving Baldringer's Godstone a wide berth. The giant's presence is missed as you continue to feel watched. Alio, what do you know about Baldringer? Not much, but enough, the Skald says. These flames symbolize Baldringer's love of fire and war. The first being a means to the second. When the Varl were dominating humans in the first great conflict, it was Baldringer who gave the losing side fire to combat the giants. You hold up your hand to halt the storyteller, listening through the rain for anything that might be following you. Hearing nothing, Alio resumes, holding the gaze of his audience. Humans praised Baldringer for the gift of fire, but the god only desired more war. He points towards the distant shapes of the Varl. When the giants and humans found peace, this godstone fell from grace. It looks to continue keeping the land scorched. Perhaps its shadow can still kill. I'll step into the godstone's shadow. Against Alio's wishes, you walk directly into the shadow of the Godstone's roots. Many clansmen gasp, not caring for your disregard. The gods are dead, you remind them. Oh, dang it. An arrow suddenly sinks into the ground near you. We're under attack, shouts Alio. Shields come up and fighters join you as you charge the enemy cloaked in the storm. Well, shoot. That was dumb. Alright, Irsa is injured. We've got no Varl. Ludin. Trigvi, Oddleif. I think that's going to be our group. See how this goes. Probably not well. Oh no, this is not going to go well at all. Cragsman Savage, Axe Storm. Oh. Another Savage. Another Savage. Hag Hurler, Cragsman Venom. Alright, well, Alright, what do we want to do? I want to go after these guys first, I think. See how this goes. Interesting icon for the Hag Hurler. Alright. Impale is just on the immediate, ooh, that is really, really good armor that they've got. Not actually sure if Impale is gonna be all that good. What do you have as abilities? Call Bear. Eric summons his trained fighting bear. Do it. What's the worst that can happen, really? Ow. Spine grinder, huh? So, Maul. Divides damage between strength and armor on up to 3 adjacent targets in front of Bear. No. Thank you. Dang it! I just accidentally gave him some defense. Alright. Might actually be best to go after the archers. Well, we'll start with these guys. Nice deflection. Oh wow, 5. That's pretty nice. I don't know that we really... Well... We got a lot. Now we'll just go with 5. Hopefully will be enough. That's enough to kill him, so let's do that. Clustered, so yeah, whoa. Alright, I'm gonna have to move her. Alright, Trigvi, let's go with Impale on you. Ah, you did not move. I don't like that. Ooh. You are in really bad shape. That is really bad for all of us involved. Let's see. Rally. Gives willpower. Alright, well, let's just use up our willpower with them. Dang it, there he goes. Alright, well, I can kill the, kill this guy. Work on damaging these two back here. Ow! Stop going out. Oh, my need is gonna go down, I think. Well, let's take out that one's armor. Probably should have gone after that one too. Her armor, but whatever. Oh, I should have moved her. I can take out her, so let's do that. That was a pretty good amount of injury that he just sustained. Armor break, unfortunately, down goes Need. That's quite annoying. You can't send you back very far, unfortunately. But you go down. That's the important thing. Going after the bear. I really, really miss my ball. Yeah. Who are you going after? Luden? That's okay. Let's see. Use one of those. Kill that guy with a bear. Not sure how the bear's renown works. I should be able to do enough, so let's go ahead and do this. There you go. Die. There we go. Well, unfortunately, two people went down. So I did not get as much renown as I might have otherwise. Having killed or run off the Cragsmen, you return to the remaining clansmen at the Godstone. Grabbing your belongings, your foot hits something in the mud. You reach down to find a small skull with a yellow ribbon through the eyes. You toss it in a bag without another thought. Gained item, Fallow's Rebirth, and achievement unlocked, Baldringer. Got 5 renown for that. Ivor, Mogan, Moger, Hakon, I really missed you guys. Thank you for coming back. The rain finally ceases, but the wind picks up. You squint into the gusts and have a clear view of the vast plains ahead. There doesn't seem to be much out there, Ivor says. His tone conveys wonder and concern in equal measure. Let's take a quick look at the map, see how far we've come. Huh. That doesn't seem to be very far. Okay. Let's keep going. Oh, there's Grundar there. I missed it. The letters blended into the background. The ground shakes again, enough to cause the ox to strain at their leads in panic. Out here in the plains, with nothing but open sky above, you feel remarkably vulnerable.
Only a few trees and around, no mountains, Hakon says in a wry tone. Looks like we only have to worry about the ground opening up beneath us.
He shrugs at the look you give him.
Grundar almost looks forgotten by the rest of the world. Maybe those who live here have forgotten the rest of us, too.
Well, let's see if they've heard anything about what's going on to the north. In a field outside Grundar, the caravan spots several creatures you assumed were myth.
I don't believe it.
Are those? Two Horseborn hold simple bronze weapons and stand guard over a few others who look wounded, unable to rise. The size of the caravan makes them nervous.
I have to get a closer look.
Odd don't. This could get ugly, or me too. Me too. The two of you advance 100 yards, showing every sign of respect and peace. A number of clansmen push closer too. The male, Horseborn, stomps a hoof repeatedly. The female, tail whipping, brandishes a javelin.
Damn, the caravan is scaring them.
Let's tell everyone to move back. A sudden shout spooks the female Horseborn. She throws a javelin which pins the ground near your feet. Whoops. Several archers fire, but their shots are wide.
Hold! No more arrows!
The male says something in what sounds like a long stream of consonants. The female lowers her second javelin.
We just want to help.
The male's tail swishes.
You help?
His voice sounds strained, and his mouth moves uncomfortably around the foreign words.
Yes, help!
Oddleif steps aside as you wave to Ivan for help. The female looks agitated. She speaks in their strange way. The male responds to her, then turns to you.
Help, Roach, and others.
I'll try. This is certainly a first.
The standing Horseborn step aside, allowing Ivan to approach the wounded fighters. With Ivan and Juno tending to the wounded Roech and other Horseborn, the caravan settles down outside the scant town of Grundar. It appears the town is enjoying a small festival. Quite a few clansmen go over the hill to enjoy the sights and sounds, but soon return looking disappointed.
They called us outsiders, a woman says. They don't want us interrupting their wheat harvesting festival. But the merchants don't seem to mind trading.
The clansmen soon shrug it off and
take renewed interest in the Horseborn. Some in awe, others in disgust. So we can talk to the Horseborn, visit our heroes, visit the market. Definitely rest. Let's see, who is injured again? You're down for 2 days, you're down for 1 day, you're down for 2 days, you're down for 1 day. Well, oh, that's you. Never mind. Oh! You guys are actually showing up now as, people in the group. Horseborn Teulu? Trample. The Horseborn charges forward and tramples an enemy, then attacks from behind. The enemy suffers strength damage during the charge. It is subsequently struck for 1 strength per tile the Horseborn moved before the trample and is left concussed, suffering 20% on his next attack. 2, 3, and 4 range. And passive ability is hit and run. The Horseborn takes his normal movement, then can attack or take another action. Once the action is completed, he can move again up to 3 spaces. No willpower may be spent on the second move. Oh, I love that ability. That sounds awesome. Also a Teulu. Mule Kick. The Horseborn delivers a devastating kick with his powerful horse's legs, damaging the target's armor, sending him flying across the battlefield, and leaving him stunned when he lands. Any other unit unfortunate enough to be in the path of the flying enemy suffers a violent hit as well. Be careful who is in the knockback path. 2 tiles, 4 tiles, 6 tiles. Also hit and run. And Horseborn Cantriff. Poison Tipped. The Horseborn uses a javelin tipped with a deadly poison to make sure the enemy doesn't forget her after the initial sting of her attack passes. The ill target becomes unable to secure their own ground and is able to be moved through. Poisons like this are often used against high-strength enemies to wear them down over time, or on a large unit that is blocking paths to other areas of the board. The doses do not stack together, but a second dose will serve to refresh the damage over time and keep the target afflicted. -1 strength per round for 3 rounds, -2 strength per round for 3 rounds, and -3 strength. Oh, that's pretty good. Free roam. While moving, each willpower the Horseborn spends allows her to travel 2 tiles instead of 1. Well, damn, I think I'm going to be swapping some people out then. They're pretty good. And this is the Fallow's Rebirth. The small skull of a Cragsman infant tied with a golden ribbon supposedly wards away death. Protects from death unless strength is 1. -3 armor. 35% dodge strength attacks. I don't know about that. I mean, Ivor does have really high strength as it is, so that could be okay. I've got 43 renown. I should probably go see what is available at the market. Let's see. Halden's Razor. Well-honed razor crafted by Halden, known for a steady hand, calm presence, and a will to exceed limits. +3 will on rest. Statue of a Sightless Man. A figurine occasionally carried by older warriors who believe it could temporarily blind their enemies. 20% dodge strength attacks, +2 strength. Tortoise Band, +2 armor on rest. An early king of men was known to have a ring that he would turn compulsively on his finger before rushing back into battle. Horse Core. Shoes made from the hooves of Horseborn have long been rumored to make one faster, if not cold-hearted. +1 move, 10% dodge strength attack. And Golden Bridle. +3 all talent ranks, +1 strength attack, +1 break. I've got a lot of renown right now. 1 renown gets 3, though. And I could always use this to promote people. I don't have anyone at rank 10 yet. I'd have to make a concerted effort to get them there. I don't know, but that +1 strength attack and +1 break and +3 all talent ranks, that is really, really good. Let's do it. Probably a bad idea. Let's see. That's... Oh, actually, 1 renown gets 3. That's a really good price, actually.
go for that. All right. Heroes. I could definitely promote some people. I should probably promote Oddleif simply because she is only rank 3 right now. She's got 23 kills. Yeah, let's go ahead and promote her. And get her a bit more strength. There we go. Alright, we'll hold the rest of it. Definitely going to look into promoting some other people. Let's go ahead and talk to the Horseborn guy.
Thank.
You glance at Ubin, who snorts and smiles. Hey, Ubin! Haven't seen you in a while.
Skavak's thanking you for helping his friend Roach. Deirdre is the other one, but she's not in a talking with Varl and humans mood.
You're welcome. I'd like you to meet Hakon.
Skathak's tail swats his flanks, and he bows his head towards Hakon.
Varl Mans, same herd?
No, but we're no longer enemies.
I haven't seen Horseborn in centuries. Last they knew, humans of Varl were at each other's throats.
What brings you so far north? We'll go with that. Skathak looks confused by the question, so Ubin shows him on the map, pointing to Dalaland and Grundar.
Food. Our planes break.
Hakon snorts.
Might be justice. Didn't they kill all the horses, Scrivener?
His ancestors did, yes. But blaming folks for things that happened hundreds of years ago before they were alive? You may as well accuse these humans around us of starting the Great Wars.
What happened to Roek?
Roek, brave fighter, protect food, hit many times.
Hit? Who was attacking? Skathak says many things in his other language. They sound kind of, it sounds like they're going for a little bit of a Welsh thing with the, or at least a Celtic theme with some of the names and... Yes. That looks Irish to me.
Trigacanthe.
His eyes go wide and he stomps the ground before pointing west. You look at Ubin.
I don't have a clue, but clearly not a friend. Was it the people here in Grundar?
Skathak looks where Hakon is pointing. He shakes his head and points west again. The Varl King eyes Skathak suspiciously. How do you know our language? Skathak just stares at you.
You talk like us. Where did you learn?
Heard little trade with men's in mud.
I think he means our bog friends, the Cragsmen.
Have you found the food you were seeking? Does that mean all the Horseborn have come north?
No.
Well, let's ask, have you found the food you were seeking?
Enough for time, my guess. Two others take to herd in south.
His hooves scuff the ground during certain words.
Just those two? What about you and the couple?
Skathak, Roek, Deirdre, you stay. This herd help. We help this herd.
Well, we'll say thank you. Skathak nods in a movement that uses most of his upper body.
Man, Varl, Horseborn, same herd. Funny.
Ubin chuckles at the as the group separates. All right. Well, it might be a good idea to rest and regain some of our people. Well, I could actually visit the training. Probably is a good idea now that we have new unit types. Nope. Apparently not. I thought the thing was glowing, meaning that I should go visit it. Let's go ahead and rest. Morale improved. We are at good. Let's rest one more day, and we'll get back up to great. And heroes are still injured? Ah, you're still down for one day. I don't know that I want to rest another day, but I kind of have to get him uninjured. Let's not. Let's pass on it. Maybe we can rest. We'll need to rest again later. It is about the end of the episode, a little bit early, so I think we'll call it. When we return, we will break camp and leave Grunder. See you then, everyone.